to, you don't put things on some forum or whatever. Okay. You go to the management company or the police. That is what you do.
There were some people in one of the buildings who you felt were ganging up on you.
I can read it now.
Yeah,
I want you in on this.
Whoa. Am I doing it?
That's perfect. That's perfect.
Oh, okay.
But
well,
you need
well,
help, honey.
Well,
get help. There are doctors that will give you medication that will help you.
Let me be the one to get you.
Okay.
No, I'm
stopping your spin.
About.
No, go. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No,
go ahead.
Because you don't shut up long enough to let anybody talk.
I just want to remind you, I have everything on tape, so it's
but
less editing.
But you have nothing on tape.
Less.
But there is nothing in these rooms, so what you're saying is true because it's all... Crazy.
Okay.
I don't need you to come closer because I don't trust you. You're crazy.
Really?
I might knock the shit out of that, my dear.
Yes, that's the problem.
I'm gonna beat her ass.
It's not
gonna
be
illegal. You're legal in jail.
Yeah.
But they know it's gonna be because of her.
It's not illegal.
I come home. I go in my home. I leave. I go to work. I do nothing.
I used to do that.
Shut
too.
Up and let me talk, you
I used
crazy
to do
whore.
That too.
I have done nothing to you.
Somebody gonna come out and clap, and I'm gonna get this shit on camera.
We need another officer to the front door to help out.
Need another. Why would fuck that, man? Fuck y'all police, nigga. Y'all can suck hard back dick, nigga. Fuck out of here, police ass. So what, man? Fuck you, dog.
Turn around and back out of the apartment. Back out the door. Back out the
fucking squall, nigga. They got that squall, nigga. They about to start shooting at me. That's what I was doing.
Thank you, George. Listen, I'm losing my audience.
I'm almost finished.
Everybody's clicking off
you
the TV.
You know what?
Thank you, George. I'm losing my audience.
I'm almost finished.
Everybody's clicking off the TV.
You know what?
This is the 2015 Black History Month family honorees. No disrespect to the deceased, but really.
Mark?
No. Polite and kind, however, extremely fake because I was trying so hard to get to the bottom, figure out what happened before someone told me, you know, to go back to my apartment and, you know, let them get away with it. Because, I mean, it had been just 6 months before August 2011, I believe, maybe early September, when the Bulls had sent the two cops to my door over the note, piece of paper on the ground outside my door, not at the Bulls' door, that said, "Dear Students of Christ the King," 6 words on it, and I've got the cops saying, "Oh,
huh? Did I take a picture of you?"
Okay, this is the tangible evidence. You said you wrote these items.
That's from my
You don't write
garden.
Letters, First of all, I wasn't born yesterday. You don't write official letters to schools like a crayon, purple crayon, or black paper.
Notes.
Okay?
Notes to myself that were in my garbage down
yourself,
here.
Whatever. You said you were writing
They
a letter.
Go in my garbage, and you're here telling me that I'm borderline criminal.
You, listen.
And you asked me why
listen,
I want to talk about it online?
Listen to me. You told me you wrote these. This is tangible evidence of potential harassment, okay? No
I also
to
told
it,
you that
no
it's from my garbage,
it,
that they took it out of my garbage.
No matter how you want to slice it.
And you want to really,
this is
like,
why I'm here, okay? This is why I'm here.
You gave that back to me, and then you took it back.
Well, it's in
I never
hand
gave
now,
it to you.
Right?
You gave it to me.
Listen,
all right?
It was in my hand, and
this
you asked for it back.
This is potential harassment, okay? You can dance around with me all you want, but what I'm telling you is the beefs that you have are civil and need to be pursued as such. And anything else you do...
Don't,
yeah, put the stick down.
Don't,
bitch. I will shove that thing so far down your motherfucking throat.
You set up and put the condition that we're not... Can I ask you a question? If that bothered you, if that was a problem.
Even the cop that came to the door said, she needs to be put away. She needs to be put away.
She just hates you more than everybody else, Robin. So when who she thinks she can be a friend with talking to you, all of a sudden.
Guess what happened? I was
friends
with Robin. And then she turned on me. I was the only person in the building still talking to her.
Yeah.
At that time.
I was. Well,
I say hi to everybody.
So I didn't get the photograph of the two prostitutes with their faces bashed in. I told the state trooper about it, who I had talked to about Daniel's girlfriend disappearing. And this was the day before Robin is whispering to him in the laundry room, telling him that she saw some of my videos on, I didn't even have it under my name, the YouTube page. At the time, it was Hellcrest Park, I think. And only Robin would be the one to look at it. This guy didn't even know my name. But anyway, the manager of the store they were in buying first aid stuff, I wandered in behind them and I was trying to get their photograph really carefully without them seeing me. But the manager saw me. He saw their faces. He was shocked, too. He was the only person on the planet that could be my witness to this, seeing this horrific. Their faces were, like, completely smashed in, worse than this picture that I found. This is the closest thing I could find that was similar to what happened, but both their black eyes swollen, their eyes were like slits, their lips were stuck out as if they had something, you know, like a plate. Anyway, the guy moved in downstairs. The manager of the store moved in downstairs. And I was talking to him a couple weeks ago, and I was like, oh my God, I can't believe it. I said, I tried to call you because I just wanted someone to acknowledge that I couldn't believe that I saw this because nobody believes me. He's like, yeah, he totally remembered. And he lives downstairs in my building now as of just a few months ago. So, I mean, he doesn't want to get involved on this, and he'll end up hating me just because I'm telling the story. And this is exactly what's going on. The idea that I'm looking at these girls who are coming in and out of this building with their faces smashed in like this, listening to all the violence, and Robin is telling him that I took photographs because the board was laughing at me, thought I was exaggerating, didn't believe me, that there were prostitutes here. I was going for quality of life.
He's not in trouble. And the police don't put people in their place when they've done nothing wrong. He's not in trouble.
Unfortunately, I can't sue you for slander.
You can tell all of us that.
Everybody knows.
It was in all the newspapers.
Everybody knows what you're about.
It was in all the news. Everybody knows what I'm about?
Yeah.
No, you fucking know I'm wrong. What?
The person who is downloading this video lies.
You don't put things on some forum or whatever.
Okay.
You go to the management company or the police. That is what you do.
There were some people in one of the buildings who you felt were ganging up on you.
But remember when Willowbrook was open? If I said you needed, they'd come and straightjack you and do a chip survey on your ass.
She's crazy. Yeah. Well, yeah, she needs to be in another house.
Yeah, I know.
And I told her to her face, she's crazy. Yeah.
Even the cop that came to the door said, she needs to be put away. She needs to
But you know what? If she was there, I would care. Because she sat up there and said to me, I heard you out here rapping and giggling.
I'm so sorry.
I know. Don't even worry about it. No, let me tell you something. My landlord told me that she was crazy.
I was playing with you when I said that.
No, my landlord told me she was crazy, right?
Everybody knows she's crazy.
And I've recorded them.
About hurting you.
She's a cuckoo.
She's crazy.
I dealt with people like that in VA, honey.
That's why she's crazy.
She's crazy. people is.
Me too.
Yeah.
But they're
I don't trust
people. I've not sacrificed in life like that.
No.
They
Yeah, no. It's
yeah.
not your fault.
Yeah,
she
not.
just cuckoo.
We seized $1.2 million worth of 100% pure heroin.
And in case you're wondering, this is what $1 million of heroin looks like.
Well, Councilman Joe Torres was called by Red House Entertainment to clean out a clogged toilet and got paid by Red House. And apparently, the toilet would have to remain clogged until the next month when the ethics board
got
around
about
to
well
it.
Well,
check out Facebook, you know what I'm saying? First floor minus. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Don't shoot. We got first floor modeling, first floor photography. You know, we got FMM, fast money movement. You know what I'm saying? That's what we do. Just came home from the feds. Green state, green feds. Man, I'm back. Gotta get the fuck out of here, man. I ain't going back. Man. That's all that they know. I ain't going back.
And Councilwoman McKenzie is on vacation. I actually cut my vacation short to be here, despite the fact that I was doing really good with this tan.
People were picked up in Yorktown, Cortland, and Peekskill for allegedly feeding a network of heroin users.
Some of these police officers are our family and our friends.
And now that former New York cop accused of running a prostitution ring, prosecutors say his customers paid up to $2,000 an hour for a hooker.
Yeah, the operation brought in millions of dollars, and among his clientele, he says some of the wealthiest people in the world.
I'm News reporter NJ Burke at the federal courthouse in downtown Brooklyn with the story. NJ.
And Bill, none of the clients are named in the court papers, and neither are the escorts. But they say there is no question about it. This was a prostitution business, a business run by retired New York City police officer Michael Rizzi, who raked in millions while on disability. Prosecutors say he ran the business out of his home in Bensonhurst, Brooklyn, for at least 4 years. An escort service using more than 50 different websites and advertising female companionship for up to $2,000 an hour. Assistant Special Agent in Charge, Stephen Schrank.
Correct. And we have certain individuals, based on credit card billing that were alleged in the complaint, that spent upwards of $100,000.
Federal agents and NYPD detectives raided Rizzi's home this morning, seizing computers and computer files. According to court papers, Rizzi insisted on personally interviewing all of the women who worked for him, writing one of them in an email, quote, "I'm sorry, darling. I get the most business. My girls make the most money. My clients are the wealthiest people in the world. I will never send a model I haven't interviewed to them." Tonight, his attorney insists there was nothing illegal about any of it.
My client ran a legitimate service, and that any time that he was made aware of any kind of illegal activity, those escorts, those models were terminated.
But in court papers, Rizzi's escorts tell a different story. They knew that they were interviewing to be prostitutes and believed that was clear, said one agent. Rizzi said they could decide what sexual acts to engage in with clients. End quote. Michael Rizzi is charged with conspiracy to commit money laundering. He was released on bail, then promptly rearrested by NYPD detectives.
I think it's real important for us. Like, I can't understand that we are seriously under attack like never before.
Thank you.
Do I have to drive you?
Yeah, please.
Okay, I'll wait for you.
All right, please.
Where we going, John? Black, going back to Jay-Z's?
Yeah, she said that I could request on Monday.
Yeah.
Any Monday.
It's a body charm, yes, rope.
Any Monday.
Do not have to lie like that. This is beforehand. Case has been dismissed. Okay, I see you on the 24th. Again, the case has been dismissed. Hi, John Castro, if I can get my bail. Can you buy ID? I can't find you.
I'm recording everything. I got my neighbors' proof. Let's see. Let's see, because you're crazy. We all know, so let's just see. Once the cops get here, they're like, oh, it's her again?
Okay, it took some of them to help a person like me get clean and better myself, change my life around, because I was out here doing drugs and alcohol. Okay, let me tell you something. Let's get real. Let me go get my people from Mount Vernon, from the Bronx, from Brooklyn, and come up here and terrorize this town to let you see what it's going to be if you don't fix what you're in damage. Okay, because these brothers and sisters out here are doing very well. These kids are outstanding. They're not out here breaking in people's houses. They're not vandalizing your porch. They ain't beat up your kids yet. They ain't did nothing to do anything out of ordinary. Okay, these police have enough.
Until that moment, Mr. Sanchez was not aware the door had been damaged, which is bullshit. I have a recording of talking to Ray about it a few times because it happened way before, like the year before this, over a year before this. This confrontation was recorded against Mr. Sanchez's wishes and caused him a sense of discomfort knowing that he might end up on social media. Mr. Sanchez asked Reyna to please leave future messages regarding property issues on his answering machine. On a recent rainy day, Reyna approached a resident, this is Robin, who was waiting for a ride in the building's hallway. Reyna told the resident that she should wait outside in the rain, in case you didn't catch that. Reyna told the resident that she should wait outside because she was annoying Reyna by waiting in the hallway. This confrontation left the resident feeling uncomfortable and concerned for her safety. These interactions between your tenant, Reyna Fortini, in case you forgot who we're talking about, and Hillcrest Park property employees and residents must cease. The property bylaws and rules and regulations clearly state.
We're going to bestow some honors on some well-known citizens.
You don't want me to sue you for your little Honda and your little condo. Don't mess with me.
Yeah?
Department. I'm saying if don't shoot, we got first floor modeling, first floor photography. You know, we got FMM, fast money movement. You know what I'm saying? That's what we do.
I'm saying, if anything, man, I'm running this and I'm skipping, man. You know what I'm saying? We got this.
Michael Rizzi is charged with conspiracy to commit money laundering. He was released on bail, then promptly rearrested by NYPD detectives.
None of these police officers are our family and our friends, okay? It took some of them to help a person like me get clean and better myself, change my life around, because I was out here doing drugs and alcohol.
To, you don't put things on some forum or whatever.
Okay.
You go to the management company or the police. That is what you do.
Leave, I go to work, I do nothing.
I used to do that.
Shut up and let me talk, you
crazy
whore.
I used to do that too.
I have done nothing to you.
But within this quiet block, Peekskill police last month made their largest heroin bust in city history.
There's something in the ethics code about transactional disclosure.
We seized $1.2 million worth of 100% pure heroin.
And in case you're wondering, this is what $1 million of heroin looks like.
Councilman Joe Torres was called by Red House Entertainment to clean out a clogged toilet and got paid by Red House. And apparently the toilet would have to remain clogged until the next month when the ethics board got
around
about
to it. Well,
check out Facebook, you know what I'm saying? First floor, modest. You know what I'm saying? Over here, man. What's up? What's up? What's up? What's up? What's up? What's up? saying? If don't shoot, we got first floor modeling, first floor photography. You know, we got FMM, fast money movement, you know what I'm saying? That's what we do. Just came home from the feds, green state, green feds, man, I'm back, gotta get the fuck out of here, man. I ain't going back, man, that's all that nigga know, I ain't going back.
And Councilwoman McKenzie is on vacation. I actually cut my vacation short to be here, despite the fact that I was doing really good with this tan.
People were picked up in Yorktown, Cortland, and Peekskill for allegedly feeding a network of heroin users.
Plus, a retired NYPD officer is now accused of running a high-end prostitution ring with dozens of websites. And good evening to you at 6 o'clock. I'm Liz Chow.
And I'm Bill Rudolph.
None of these police officers are our family and our friends.
And now that former New York cop accused of running a prostitution ring, prosecutors say his customers paid up to $2,000 an hour for a hooker.
Yeah, the operation brought in millions of dollars, and among his clientele, he says some of the wealthiest people in the world.
Eyewitness News reporter NJ Burke at the federal courthouse in downtown Brooklyn with the story. NJ.
And Bill, none of the clients are named in the court papers, and neither are the escorts, but they say there is no question about it. This was a prostitution business, a business run by retired New York City police officer Michael Rizzi, who raked in millions while on disability. Prosecutors say he ran the business out of his home in Bensonhurst, Brooklyn, for at least 4 years. An escort service using more than 50 different websites and advertising female companionship for up to $2,000 an hour. Assistant Special Agent in Charge, Stephen Schrank.
Correct. And we have certain individuals, based on credit card billing that were alleged in the complaint, that spent upwards of $100,000.
Federal agents and NYPD detectives raided Rizzi's home this morning, seizing computers and computer files. According to court papers, Rizzi insisted on personally interviewing all of the women who worked for him, writing one of them in an email, quote, "I'm sorry, darling. I get the most business. My girls make the most money. My clients are the wealthiest people in the world. I will never send a model I haven't interviewed to them." Tonight, his attorney insists there was nothing illegal about any of it.
My client ran a legitimate service, and that any time that he was made aware of any kind of illegal activity, those escorts, those models were terminated.
But in court papers, Rizzi's escorts tell a different story. They knew that they were interviewing to be prostitutes and believed that was clear, said one agent. Rizzi said they could decide what sexual acts to engage in with clients. End quote. Michael Rizzi is charged with conspiracy to commit money laundering. He was released on bail, then promptly rearrested by NYPD detectives.
I think it's really important for us. Like, I can't understand that we are seriously under attack like never before.
Hold on a second. Let me pull your file and see what's
Thank
up.
You.
Hi, John Castro, if I can get my bail. You need my ID?
Recording everything. I got my neighbors' proof. Let's see. Let's see, because you're crazy. We all know, so let's just see. Once the cops hear it, they're like, oh, it's her again?
Okay, it took some of them to help a person like me get clean and better myself, change my life around, because I was out here doing drugs and alcohol. Okay, let me tell you something. Let's get real. Let me go get my people from Mount Vernon, from the Bronx, from Brooklyn, and come up here and terrorize this town to let you see what it's going to be if you don't fix what you done damaged. Okay, because these brothers and sisters out here are doing very well. These kids are outstanding. They're not out here breaking in people's houses. They're not vandalizing your porch. They ain't beat up your pin yet. They ain't did nothing to put anything out of ordinary. Okay, these police have enough.
Until that moment, Mr. Sanchez was not aware the door had been damaged, which is bullshit. I have a recording of talking to Ray about it a few times because it happened way before, like the year before this, over a year before this. This confrontation was recorded against Mr. Sanchez's wishes and caused him a sense of discomfort knowing that he might end up on social media. Mr. Sanchez asked Reyna to please leave future messages regarding property issues on his answering machine. On a recent rainy day, Reyna approached a resident, this is Robin, who was waiting for a ride in the building's hallway. Reyna told the resident that she should wait outside in the rain, in case you didn't catch that. Reyna told the resident that she should wait outside because she was annoying Reyna by waiting in the hallway. This confrontation left the resident feeling uncomfortable and concerned for her safety. These interactions between your tenant, Reyna Fortini, in case you forgot who we're talking about, and Hillcrest Park property employees and residents must cease. The property bylaws and rules and regulations clearly state.
We're going to bestow some honors on some well-known citizens.
You don't want me to sue you for your little Honda and your little condo. Don't mess with me.
Pop that, nigga. They got the squall, nigga. They about to start shooting at these niggas. That's what I would do. Somebody's gonna come out clapping. I'm gonna get this shit on camera.
All right, we need another officer to the front door to help out.
Need another? Why would you fuck that, man? Fuck y'all police, nigga. Y'all can suck hard back dick, nigga. Fuck out of here, police ass.
Just came home from the feds, bringing the feds, man. I'm
that's harassment.
They're bullying me. They're harassing me.
And that's all they need to know. I ain't going back.
They're all on.
No one's ever said anything to me.
But they get pissed off at
you. Oh, really? So why don't they say, hey, why don't we, you know, like, call it a truce and we'll leave you alone and you take that down?
Because they don't want a truce.
Oh, because that would be too civilized?
Maybe. Because they don't want a truce. Because they don't want a truce. Because they don't want a truce.
So why don't you come up, Pam, and bring your relatives with you?
Are you Con Edison? So get away from my fucking door.
So why don't you come up, Pam?
Yes, I will.
Bring your your relatives.
You can't call the cop for shit. You can't call the cop for shit. You can't call the cop for shit.
You can't do anything.
So why don't you come up, Pam, and bring your relatives with you?
Here.
You sleep with your dog, like.
And Peekskill police don't intimidate anybody, let alone their own citizens. I'm sticking up for them. You know, the people that think they were intimidated, let them come here and tell it. I'd like to hear from them, but it's just not true.
Never had anything like this. There you go. Are you Con Edison? So get away from my fucking door. Because you've been knocking on my door all morning. Get the fuck away from my door. What do you want my door for?
You gotta chill out.
No, I'm not chilling out. You've been...
Call me Rain Goodall. And if that sounds racist, so be it.
ask the Peekskill Police Department how many times this woman filed false police reports against me over the past 15 years. They couldn't tell you, however, how certain employers' background checks, I guess through conversation, because I don't really know how background checks work, how they ended up costing me everything. Late in life, at this point, after an accident, I really have nothing anymore. With $10 million, this woman wouldn't think about going to Europe, taking her kids on a cross-country trip. I mean, think of all of your dreams coming true. Well, you know, to some degree. But this is an example how money really means nothing. Followed by this woman when I go to the grocery store. This started over 2 years ago when this man threatened to put a hammer in my head.
That's a threat to me!
You don't have to get closer!
That's a threat to me!
You don't... I'm sorry, when someone gets their head... They're threatening to get their head bashed in.
How many times do I have to repeat the same thing to you over and over again? I'm actually...
Ditto. I called you because I was scared.
This is my last time I'm going to say it.
And I started paying attention.
Wait, don't move. Stay there, stay. Mickey, stay.
I know that woman.
Which one?
The woman with the green top.
So I asked Pam McNair to come.
So what, man? Fuck these Poughkeepsie police, man.
Yeah, she... Oh,
well,
it's a cop, too.
No, somebody, she got a female that came out the house and arrested. What? She came out with her hands up? Yeah.
A girl came out with her
hands. That's a female. Somebody
coming out?
Fuck, Tony. They about to run up in there. Oh, shit, there they go.
Let's see, because you're crazy. We all know, so let's just see. Once the cops get here, they're like, oh, it's her again? They're like, we've been here four different times for four different people.
So why don't you come up, Pam, and bring your relatives with you?
About. We'll see when the cops get here.
Yeah.
That's what you gotta say. I'll wait for them.
Somebody's gonna come out clapping, and I'm gonna get this shit on camera.
All right, we need another officer to the front door to help out.
Need another... Fuck that, man. Fuck y'all police, nigga. Y'all can suck hard back dick, nigga. Fuck out of here, police ass. So what?
We just couldn't honor everybody.
You're gonna go back to the psycho home. That's all you're gonna do.
Psycho
home? You've been there four times.
Without my computer.
You've been there four times.
Really?
Four times. I recorded you go on my property last night. I'm gonna get you locked up if I can get you locked up.
Get me locked up now, Mark.
Listen
to me.
Some of these police officers are our family and our friends.
What's up, bitch? Come out your door right now.
No, I'm sorry. That does not constitute harassment.
She went into it one day when she said, I came up, she said, can I ask you a question? I said, no.
Right.
She said, I just want no.
I just tried to say Merry Christmas, and you just threatened to bash my dog. Wait, how did it start? Why is that? Because I said Merry Christmas?
Because I don't want you saying a motherfucking thing to me.
And that's because I said...
As long as you live, and I'll be happy.
Oh, this is a quick, easy question. You just threatened to bash my head in. You just threatened to bash my head in when I said Merry Christmas.
No, I threatened that when you started calling me all these motherfucking names.
What name did I call you?
That's a threat to me.
You don't have to get closer.
That's a threat to me.
You don't have to get closer.
My name is Daniel. If you can't use it, shut the fuck up.
Beep.
I ain't even do nothing.
Beep.
Call on me. I ain't even do nothing.
Which forces me to listen.
What's up, bitch? Come out your door right now.
And what's going to happen?
So, you didn't say anything else? No, I'm sorry. That does not constitute harassment.
Call the police.
You've been on
sleeping in these rooms. I don't know what you're saying. It's all crazy land.
Okay.
I don't need you to come closer because I don't trust you. You're crazy.
Really?
If I say I'm going to beat your ass, I'll beat your ass.
Okay.
If you want to look at your phone and record that shit? Go record it.
Don't say nothing to none of my kids. I'm warning you. Videotape that. That's a warning. That's a.
You can't both talk at the same time. People can't watch it on TV.
Just call me. I'm just saying how you do it. No, just say how you do it. I'm going to show you how you do it.
Just couldn't honor everybody.
I'm about to start shooting at these niggas. That's what I would do. That's what I would do. That's what I would do. That's what I would do.
The FBI, now part of the investigation, the county hopes will put a dent in heroin traffic north of the city. New at 6 tonight, CBS 2's Lou Young reports from Peekskill.
For everything you said about everybody, let me be the one to get you.
I got my neighbors as proof. Let's see.
Turn around and back out of the apartment. Back out the door.
They got the fucking squad, my nigga. Pop that, nigga. They got the squad, nigga. They about to start shooting at these niggas. That's what I would do.
We just couldn't honor everybody.
No, see.
How many times did you call the police on me?
Twice.
Guess what? Carol, Robin, Dolores, Pam, Glennis doesn't have anything to do with it.
You're a lying fucking bitch, and I'm gonna fuck you up.
Don't,
oh, yeah.
Don't.
Put the stick down.
Don't,
bitch. I will shove that thing so far down your motherfucking throat. You are lying. I never sold anything out of my apartment ever.
Oh, really?
Okay, no. I don't
because
sell.
I sell pussy. Because I spent the past.
Pussy.
I said, I will whip your.
That's why I
said.
For sure, that's why
I said, I will whip
your.
That's
on
YouTube.
With what? With the knife?
Yeah.
With the knife?
Yeah. With the knife that you found in the hallway.
With the bread knife?
Recording everything. I got my neighbors as proof. Let's see.
Even the cop that came to the door said, she needs to be put away. She needs to
be
she
you don't put things on some forum or whatever.
Okay.
You go to the management company or the police. That is what you do.
Oh, you didn't hear it? You didn't hear it?
No.
Yes, I banged on your fucking door.
Can he just say no? He's not really going to bash my head in?
I'm not even though. I just said don't speak to me. Now you're telling me to answer her?
That's
retarded.
No, it's reasonable.
I'm not going to say no. I don't want her speaking to me. But see, because she wants me to answer that, I'm supposed to answer that? I don't want... You turn around and say...
So I have to worry that he's going to bash my head in. Is that right? You can't say no to that? With a cop here, you can't tell me that...
The last time I'm going to say it. If you interrupt me, I'm just leaving because I'm not going to do this anymore.
Like you did before.
Okay, have a good day, ma'am.
Yes.
It took months for my morning glories to grow, and I had to take them off the patio, put them in the kitchen. I mean, it's like living in a relaxed prison atmosphere or something like.
So this is lovely.
That's right, a fish stick featuring the likeness of Jesus.
Pam, I've never seen you so quiet.
You, Pam, I know
you should not.
I know that you lied letter with the police.
You shouldn't have wrote the letter, bitch, if you don't.
You should mind your own business.
Come downstairs and tell me. Come downstairs and
you
tell me, bitch.
Business.
Come downstairs and tell me. Because you know what? You know I'm going to get you.
Morning. Get the fuck away from my door before I call the cops. I've been recording you all morning.
Colin.
Get the fuck away from my shit.
Colin. We gotta call.
Because
the cops.
I've been recording you all fucking morning, so go ahead and do what you gotta do.
Colin.
Get the fuck away from my door.
Let's call him.
Simple as that.
Why didn't call the cops?
I don't give a fuck. You can't call the cops for shit.
Because
you're a crazy bitch. Did door. Simple as that. There ain't shit to talk about. Get the fuck away from my door, you crazy bitch.
You destroyed your life yourself with your own actions.
Oh, really?
With what you do to people. You created this mess.
Unfortunately, I can't sue you for slander.
Then you can tell all of us that.
Everybody knows.
It was in all the newspapers.
Everybody knows what you're about.
It was in all the news. Everybody knows what I'm about.
And the council got together to decide who we should honor for Black History Month.
You can't call the cop for shit. You can't call the cop for shit. You can't call the cop for shit.
You can't do anything. I'm recording everything. I got my neighbors' proof. Let's see. Let's see, because you're crazy. We all know. So let's just see. Once the cops get here, they're like, oh, it's her again? They're like, we've been here four different times for four different people.
So I asked Pam McNair to come.
It was the overdose deaths of 85 heroin users in this county that got the FBI involved with county and local police.
Yeah, because when did we stop being friends?
When did we ever start being friends? I was never your friend.
To, you don't put things on some forum or whatever.
Okay.
You go to the management company or the police. That is what you do.
It has been reported like as if I'm being spied on. I mean, that is what it looks like. I don't think that's the case at all. It has been reported is just the wording he used. Okay, we didn't get a letter on official letterhead from somebody claiming to be from the CIA that said they saw your car in a non-numbered spot.
So I sound like a Mel Gibson character from a conspiracy theory movie.
Well, you seem to be pretty convinced that everybody's picking on you, and I don't live up there, so I don't know what it's...
Well, actually, I was just repeating myself over and over again because I thought you seemed like a nice woman, and...
I am.
I don't see how you can't see what I see from my point of view. People do it all the time. If I was a relative or a close friend, you might have it in you to say it is kind of messed up, but...
I don't get to say that. I'm at work. And thus, I'm a representative of VIP, and we represent the board of Hillcrest.
So why don't you come up, Pam, and bring your relatives with you?
You can't call the cop for shit! You can't call the cop for shit! You can't call the cop for shit!
You can't do anything!
Leave, I go to work, I do nothing.
I used to do that.
Shut up and let me talk, you crazy whore!
I used to do that, too.
I have done nothing to you.
But within this quiet block, Peekskill police last month made their largest heroin bust in city history.
There's something in the ethics code about transactional disclosure.
How did it start?
Shut the fuck up and let me finish talking and I'll tell
you. Okay.
You put a note under my door.
Now you're dealing with me.
Okay.
You go to the management company or the police. That is what you do.
Only delusional people stand at their windows and doorways and record everything.
You mean prostitutes and people who threaten violence?
Everything.
Yeah, I do.
You've got nothing else to do.
You're gonna shut up and you're gonna listen to me.
I thought the one with Donna Johnson on it, which I'm sure she would love to know about.
Who's Donna Johnson?
Donna Johnson, 8A, I believe. There were
Donna Johnson?
There were some people in one of the buildings who you felt were ganging up on you.
Donna Johnson?
Might not have been Donna Johnson. Might have been somebody else.
Where a sexual assault, rape, of two female minors by five minors were reported, and after a three-month investigation, all six juveniles were arrested.
You don't put things on some forum or whatever.
Okay.
You go to the management company or the police. That is what you do.
They communicate via email on a daily basis.
And if I leave my car in the shade for 15 minutes, that's my point. That should alarm everybody. And if you all think it's a big joke, then this will really put her over the edge. That's what this is. That's why I'm documenting every detail of this entire quote-unquote issue. You had to and what about everyone else's door, which looks 1,000 times worse than mine, including yours?
They have not been repainted.
Ever. When was the last time they were painted? 6 years ago?
Oh, at least.
And so why am I being charged?
You're being charged because you went ahead and tried to paint your door and made it worse than it was, so we had to repaint your door. Very simple.
So slightly off-color gray spots, in your opinion, are worse than brown shit spots.
I don't know about that.
Well, I guess what about...
looked at your door, and it was a mess, and the board said repaint that door.
There was a field trip apparently that day at the board meeting. They all came down to look at my door.
Oh, I doubt that.
I doubt it too. So.
I'm only here to deal with the complaint. I really don't care about your lawsuit, their lawsuit, whoever's lawsuit. It's not my concern. I don't deal with civil stuff. I deal with criminal stuff, and you're borderline criminal. Okay? Which is why we're telling you to leave them alone. They bug you.
I haven't seen them in a week.
If they bug you, pull out your camera on your phone and record stuff. That way you have evidence. I've told them the same thing.
Well, in your obviously like non-cultured opinion, because you could barely notice.
My what opinion?
Uncultured opinion.
Thank you.
Oh yeah, he's a tyrant, all right. Are we finished?
Okay, that's where you're wrong. Now, if you take it and file a claim against Hillcrest Park Management.
He wasn't on the management.
Okay,
it
doesn't have nothing to do with management. He's a board member. He's elected by the people who live here.
I filed a form on Friday, which is why they're doing this.
I don't care.
I can tell.
The board told us to write a letter. We wrote a letter.
He's a board member. He's elected by the people who live here.
But it's just funny how this place is just so questionable in many, many, many respects.
He's a board member. He's elected by the people who live here.
The board told us to write a letter. We wrote a letter.
He's a board member.
Well, you seem to be pretty convinced that everybody's picking on you.
All right. Thank you. Have a good night. Before we close, somebody... Oh, we have another? Oh, God. Please.
That's a threat to me.
You don't have to get closer.
That's a threat to me.
You don't...
did you call me to argue with me? Please tell me what you also did wrong.
He's not in trouble. And the police don't put people in their place when they've done nothing wrong.
She by two, she won't come the next day. But if she by one, she'll come every day. The trick is that to keep her. That's consistency. Whenever they call, I have
it. 15, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 15.
Worry that he's gonna bash my head in. Is that right? You can't say no to that.
I'm only here to deal with the complaint. I really don't care about your lawsuit, their lawsuit, whoever's lawsuit. It's not my concern. I don't deal with civil stuff. I deal with criminal stuff, and you're borderline criminal. Okay, which is why we're telling you to leave them alone. They bug you.
I haven't seen them in a week.
If they bug you, pull out your camera on your phone and record stuff. That way you have evidence. I've told them the same thing.
Only delusional people stand at their windows and doorways and record everything.
You mean prostitutes and people who threaten violence?
Everything.
Yeah, I do.
Got nothing else to do.
I'm only here to deal with the complaint. I really don't care about your lawsuit, their lawsuit, whoever's lawsuit. It's not my concern. I don't deal with civil stuff. I deal with criminal stuff, and you're borderline criminal. Okay? Which is why we're telling you to leave them alone. They bug you.
I haven't seen them in a week.
If they bug you, pull out your camera on your phone and record stuff. That way you have evidence. I've told them the same thing.
Madam, now you're dealing with me.
We just couldn't honor everybody. So I asked Pam McNair.
And it looks like he tried to turn on his own electricity, and in doing so, fried someone else's apartment. The door is all mangled open, and all
that's
I did was ask him if he was
crazy.
I didn't want to call the police on him or get him in trouble or anything.
She's psycho.
Who did that?
Al Edison did it.
Right. Bitch, don't you ever talk to a mother. Like that, bitch, disrespect a motherfucking man. Man, check your bitch before I stop you.
And stop harassing us. Because it's just going to help prove the case that you're crazy. No, sweetheart, see, if I wasn't recording, you would tell the police that I... Wait, why were the police at my door threatening to arrest me because I left a note on the floor? I don't know, honey. Go get help.
No. I still have
no more of this. We don't want to hear any more complaints.
Can I have that?
Right now, this is the end of the complaint. You know?
That's my garbage.
Well, it was out in here.
And what is it? What does it say? Is there a name on it?
It says, dear
students of Christ the King.
Listen, you admitted that you wrote it. It was the central piece of your complaint that you're leaving notes around. It's bothering the woman. Okay? There's other allegations made, but this is the only thing that we could, tangible, you know what I mean?
I come home, I go in my home, I leave, I go to work, I do nothing.
I used to do that too.
I have done nothing to you.
One lie. That I have been harassing you for years.
Oh.
Tell me, what exactly have I done to harass you for years?
I mind my own business.
Because they keep calling us. They're the ones calling. Whatever's going on, they're the ones calling.
Wait, why were the police at my door threatening to arrest me because I left a note on the floor?
I don't know, honey. Go get help.
You mean these neighbors that have been harassing me since 2006?
They're saying you've been harassing them. So
how is that? This is how I'm harassing them?
This is why I wanted to do this aside. Now you're getting loud.
I have no support.
Hey, listen, you're dangerously close. For me, you lock up for being loud. Yeah, you need to drop. Which is why I wanted to do this inside. To stop that. You have to realize that we're investigating.
Okay.
We have neighbors. Do you want to take this inside now, or do you want to end up speaking too loud again?
Lies that damage someone's reputation.
I don't know anything about you getting beat up because I've never seen or heard anything of that.
Oh, really? But you do watch the videos.
I'm not really concerned about you. I don't really give a hoot about you either.
Apparently you do.
Well, Pat, you do because you're the one that puts video clips on YouTube about people.
About my life.
No, I don't think so.
Oh, lies. Oh.
Who's else? Lies.
Lies?
Could you have the volume up loud enough so that you can hear me? Because I'm sure that'll go on too.
The person who is downloading this video lies.
And anytime I ever try to offer my services in any way, my time to just help out in some way, I mean, as far back as I offered to do a website for the place. And the next day I get letters about, like, my dog.
They don't make the fines. The people who run this complex make the fines, okay? They're responsible for fining and not fining people. They find that you're in violation, you get fined. If you have a problem with that, you take it up in small claims court with the building, not individual people who live in here.
We can go to city court and to the courthouse and find out what it is to the court. The only way to do that is to stand outside waiting and have you know which is going to go out. And if she knows your family, she's not going to do it. But we shall hear. But you could bring that up to the board. The fact that she's not going to come here, the board has a right to question that.
They don't make the fines. The people who run this complex make the fines. Okay? They're responsible for
fining and not fining people. If they find that you're in violation, you get fined. If you have a problem with that, you take it up in small claims court with the building, not individual people who live in here.
You might want to bring that up to them. Dan Hathaway asked Dan about the policy for dogs. Does it have to be wearing a tag or something? They have to provide health because I looked it up today. I know it's pretty long. It's the one you're calling.
Frank, you know, why?
Because
you might have the areas where the parents want to
go. Yeah, it's too good. My life has just gotten worse now. I have to go back to the days of carrying bottles and all the time. All the time. Every day. It is me.
I'm not talking to you anymore because you know what? I have not done anything to you. In all of these years, I have done nothing. I mind my own business. I come home, I go in my home, I leave, I go to work, I do nothing.
I used to do that too.
And let me talk, you crazy whore.
I used to do that too.
I have done nothing to you. Yet you get away from my car because I don't trust you, you crazy thing.
You don't want me to sue you for your little Honda and your little condo. Don't mess with me.
So I asked Pam McNair to come. So why don't you come up, Pam, and bring your relatives with you?
We need another officer to the front door to help out.
Need another.
Why would you fuck that, man? Fuck y'all police, nigga. Y'all can suck hard back dick, nigga. Fuck out of here, police ass.
If you're being harassed, you contact the management company or the police. That's it. That's what adults do.
That's a threat to me.
You don't have to get closer.
That's a threat to me.
You don't. I'm sorry, when someone gets their head, they're threatening to get their head bashed in.
How many times do I have to repeat the same thing to you over and over again? I'm actually.
Ditto. I called you because I was scared.
This is my last time I'm going to say it.
He's not in trouble.
I come home, I go in my home, I leave, I go to work, I do nothing.
I used to do that too.
Shut up and let me talk, you crazy whore.
I used to do that too.
I have done nothing to you.
Well, this is not actually bad. Yeah, this is Raina Ortiz.
You can.
How do you know it's a prostitute, number one?
Bitch, don't you ever talk to a motherfucking pep like that, bitch. Disrespect a motherfucking man. Man, check your bitch before I stop.
This was around 11:30 that night, an hour and a half previous to this, a woman named Lisa, or that's what she called herself. I think I even heard him call her Lisette, said to a man named Mike on the stairs, quote,
I am going to take her coke money. I know what I'm doing, end quote. And they whispered a lot. And then next thing you know, the other woman is being taken to the hospital. When I was watching this, I wasn't sure which one it was. But I called the hospital out of curiosity. And I even sent the link to the police. I'm not sure whatever came of it, but I'm pretty sure they didn't even like listen to the recording that I made. So this woman was deliberately poisoned and robbed. I even called the hospital and they told me that I should call the police.
I said, wussy.
He's not in trouble.
I come home, I go in my home, I leave, I go to work, I do nothing.
I used to do that too.
I have done nothing to you.
But I know, I told the cops, I said, I don't even speak to the troll.
No,
I don't speak to her.
Yeah, nobody does anymore.
Punch her on face though.
Here investigating it because we have to, but do you know what I mean? There's much more critical things we need to be doing than mediating problems with you adults who can't get along. Okay?
Live, man. I'm saying AKA Pimp Juice, AKA Mr. International, man.
What do I do? Okay.
For the budget, please say aye.
No.
All opposed, say nay.
Yay.
The ayes have it.
Okay, now. You wrote it and I saw it. It doesn't matter. Now you're dealing with me. Now you're dealing with me.
And neither are the escorts, but they say there is no question about it. This was a prostitution business, a business run by retired New York City police officer Michael Rizzi, who raked in millions while on disability. Prosecutors say he ran the business out of his home in Bensonhurst, Brooklyn, for at least 4 years. An escort service using more than 50 different websites and advertising female companionship for up to $2,000 an hour. Assistant Special Agent in Charge, Stephen Schrank.
Correct. And we have certain individuals, based on credit card billing that were alleged in the complaint, that spent upwards of $100,000.
Federal agents and NYPD detectives raided Rizzi's home this morning, seizing computers and computer files. According to court papers, Rizzi insisted on personally interviewing all of the women who worked for him, writing one of them in an email, quote, "I'm sorry, darling. I get the most business. My girls make the most money. My clients are the wealthiest people in the world. I will never send a model I haven't interviewed to them." Tonight, his attorney insists there was nothing illegal about any of it.
My client ran a legitimate service, and that any time that he was made aware of any kind of illegal activity, those escorts, those models were terminated.
But in court papers, Rizzi's escorts tell a different story. They knew that they were interviewing to be prostitutes and believed that was clear, said one agent. Rizzi said they could decide what sexual acts to engage in with clients. End quote.
Because you know what? I have not done anything to you.
You don't have to get closer.
That's a threat to me.
You don't have to get closer.
My name is Daniel. If you can't use it, shut the fuck up.
I ain't even
do nothing.
I have done nothing.
I ain't even do nothing.
You have been told it's a civil matter, okay? They don't make the fines. The people who run this complex make the fines, okay? They're responsible for fining and not fining people. If they find that you're in violation, you get fined. If you have a problem with that, you take it up in small claims court with the building, not individual people who live in here, okay? That's where you're wrong. Now, if you take it file a claim against Hillcrest Park Management.
He wasn't on the management.
They,
when
they doesn't have nothing to do with management. He's a board member. He's elected by
the
people who live here.
I filed a form on Friday, which is why they're doing this.
I don't care.
I can tell.
All right, that's not concerned me.
Are you giving that back to me?
Here to deal with the complaint. I really don't care about your lawsuit, their lawsuit, whoever's lawsuit. It's not my concern. I don't deal with civil stuff. I deal with criminal stuff. And you're borderline criminal, okay? Which is why we're telling you to leave them alone. If they bug you.
I haven't seen them in a week.
If they bug you, pull out your camera on your phone and record stuff. That way you have evidence. I've told them the same thing.
Yeah, with the knife? With the knife that you found in the hallway.
Engage with you. You'll see.
Okay.
Well, then why did you bang on my door?
Why did you bang on mine?
I don't need to call the cops.
I don't need to call the cops.
I'll call them too.
What are you going to tell them? That you threatened to beat me up?
Shit. If I say I'm going to beat your ass, I'll beat your ass.
Okay.
You want to look at your phone and record that shit? Go record it.
You don't put things on some forum or whatever.
Okay.
You go to the management company or the police. That is what you do.
And I have to spend 4 months fighting with you about a dog. Do you ever have a dog? Do you ever bond with a dog?
I saw the terming website you had up. That was nice.
I don't know which one you saw, but I have about 200 websites.
Okay, I saw the one with Donna Johnson on it.
your son. You don't even fucking take care of your son.
Let's make the because we're gonna bestow some honors on some well-known citizens.
You don't want me to sue you for your little Honda and your little condo. Don't mess with me.
You mean you and your $10 million money?
Uh-huh, that.
Yeah, that's what you're gonna do with it.
I have a top 8 lawyer that will chew you apart. Okay, ugly.
Wow. Well.
Ugly. Okay, ugly.
Wow. Okay, Wiggy.
I don't live here.
Yeah, but you used to.
She brings on herself, that's all.
That's better. Do you realize you cost me work? You
how
cost
did
me
I
my
cost
life.
You work? How did I affect your work?
You're not going to own this conversation.
No, how did I affect your work?
But it's just funny how the place is just so questionable in many, many, many respects.
He's not in trouble.
That's a threat to me.
You don't have to get
closer. That's a threat to me.
You don't.
Ma'am, listen, did you call me to argue with me? Please tell me what you actually did wrong.
He's not in trouble. And the police don't put people in their place when they've done nothing wrong.
He's telling him that I was taking pictures.
Hey.
Yeah?
I don't need
him. Yeah, okay.
I'll put it in.
Communicate via email on a daily basis. And where
and if I leave my car in the shade for 15 minutes, that's my point. That should alarm everybody. And if you all think it's a big joke, then this will really put her over the edge. That's what this is. That's why I'm documenting every detail of this entire quote-unquote issue.
I'm only here to deal with the complaint. I really don't care about your lawsuit, their lawsuit, whoever's lawsuit. It's not my concern. I don't deal with civil stuff. I deal with criminal stuff, and you're borderline criminal. Okay?
Borderline,
which is why we're telling you to leave them alone. They bug you.
I haven't seen them in a week.
If they bug you, pull out your camera on your phone and record stuff. That way you have evidence. I've told them the same thing.
Only delusional people stand at their windows and doorways and record everything.
You mean prostitutes and people who threaten violence?
Everything.
Yeah, I do.
You've got nothing else to do.
I deal with criminal stuff, and you're borderline criminal. Okay?
Borderline,
which is why we're telling you to leave them alone.
The board told us to run a red letter. We wrote a letter.
He's a board member.
Stay away from her. Don't go near her.
There's no. See,
how many times did you call the police on me?
Twice.
Only twice?
Only twice.
And why did you call the police?
Because
you were
harassing me.
Really?
Because you were harassing
me. What was the first time?
When you put those stupid ass notes in the hallway, I think that was
what,
the first time.
What notes?
Police department.
Oh,
we're trying to be so just like okay, we're here investigating why this woman is in tears, okay? Whatever reason, she's saying, you know, XYZ, okay? We need to talk to you. Yes, tears, yeah.
Dear students of Christ the King, go for it. I'll give you the phone number. You can call them yourself.
We're here investigating a complaint. This woman is in tears. Police department. They're saying you harassing her. So
how is that? This is how I'm harassing her?
See, this is why I want to do this inside. Now you're getting loud.
I have no
secret. Hey, listen, you're dangerously close. Which is why I wanted to do this inside.
Because you
want
to
wait,
play.
So that was the first time you called the police?
I think so.
And that scared you? When you, I also have you on tape saying, here's the number. Give him a call.
Go for it. I'll give you the phone number. You can call him yourself.
I didn't say it scared me. I said you're harassing me.
How did you feel harassed?
So I just asked this guy if he could move to park somewhere else. And I think he's the one that made me have a flat tire this morning when he was between his cars washing it. So there's my flat tire. And now he just gets out and is practically threatening me, coming over to me. And that's how I live in this fucking hell of a hole.
How do you know it's a prostitute, number one?
Well, I guess.
How do you know it's his unit, number two?
Because.
How do you know he's not doing laundry?
He says he's going to pay them $75 each, $150 for a double.
Imagine not being able to do laundry because the prostitutes are doing their hair in your laundry room. After the pimp spit on me yesterday for taking a picture while in my car driving away, Officer Nappy said to me, well, how do you know they're prostitutes?
How do I know she's a prostitute?
So I texted her and said, are we still doing it? Because I ain't know nothing about it. The bitch is a lying motherfucker. That's what he said. Yeah, man. No, I know. It's all right. Yeah, she gonna go around and fuck whoever she want. I just gotta be okay with that. I said, well, I'm just telling you to your face why I did that. You text me asking why I asked her that. That's why I asked her that. He said, no, man, everything cool, it's all right. I did like this. I'm not the shit fuck with me. I don't do it.
If you're being harassed, you contact the management company or the police. That's it. That's what adults do.
That's why I called the police a couple of hours ago and asked him what the advice was.
And he told you what you were explaining?
No, he told me to talk to Johansson tomorrow. Because this woman...
You're going to talk me in circles, but am I making sense? What are you going to run on the internet and post stuff? What is that going to do? What is that going to do? Do you want to solve the problem or do you just want to stew in the drama? Like, what do you want to do here?
They're going to find me...
What do you want to do here?
Thousands of dollars.
Who's going to find you thousands of dollars?
That's what I'm trying to tell you. That's what I was told this morning.
Thousands of dollars about what?
Across the street and the other board member told me that in email they have spoken about my taking him to small claims court.
That is a civil complaint.
And they are accruing legal fees.
That has nothing to do with
that will come.
Will you be quiet and listen to me? That has nothing to do with why we're here. We're here about alleged harassment allegations made against you, okay? This is the tangible evidence. You said you wrote these items.
You
don't write letters. First of all, I wasn't born yesterday. You don't write official letters to schools like a crayon, purple crayon, or black paper.
Notes.
Okay?
Notes to myself that were in my garbage down
yourself,
here.
Whatever. You said you were writing
They go in my garbage, and you're here telling me that I'm borderline criminal.
You... Listen,
and you asked me why I want to talk about it online?
Listen to me. You told me you wrote these. This is tangible evidence of potential harassment. Okay? No matter how
I also
you
told you
it,
that
no
it's from my garbage,
it,
that they took it out of my garbage.
No matter how you want to slice it.
And you want to really,
this is
like,
why I'm here. Okay? This is why I'm here.
You gave that back to me, and then you took it back.
Well,
you gave it to me.
Listen,
all right. It was in my hand, and
this
you asked for it back.
This is potential harassment. Okay, you can dance around with me all you want, but what I'm telling you is the beefs that you have are civil and need to be pursued as such. And anything else you do.
That's Pam McNair dumping. That's funny. That is a Lincoln, isn't it?
That car? That car?
Yeah.
I don't know nothing about cars.
That's Pam, right?
Yeah, that's Pam. Oh yeah, I don't know nothing about cars.
Get out of the road, please.
And then, okay, so my health is directly related to this disrespect.
I am not a spy.
Instigating the other people breaking down my door.
Where is it?
No, my landlord told me she was crazy, right?
I said, pussy.
That's a threat to me.
You don't have to get closer.
That's a threat to me.
You don't have to get closer.
That's a threat to me.
You don't.
Standing in a hallway, I just...
I said, pussy.
So we went into it one day when she said, I came up, she said, can I ask you a question? I said, no.
Right.
She said, I just want.
But she doesn't stop.
You're the primary instigator in this specific case.
Well, you seem to be pretty convinced that everybody's picking on you.
To, oh, you don't put things on some forum or whatever.
Okay.
You go to the management company or the police. That is what you do.
In all of these years, I have done nothing. I mind my own business.
Because they keep calling us. They're the ones calling. Whatever's going on, they're the ones calling.
Because you
wait,
want to play.
So that was the first time you called the police?
I think so. I
and that,
know,
that
I
scared you?
Okay, we're here investigating a complaint. This woman is in tears, okay? Whatever reason, she's saying, you know, X, Y, Z. Okay, we need to talk to you. Yes, tears, yeah. All right? And we need this to stop because, frankly, this kind of shit, if you'll excuse my language, it, you know, we're here investigating because we have to, but do you know what I mean? There's much more critical things we need to be doing than mediating problems with you adults who can't get along, okay?
I also have you on tape saying, here's the number. Give him a call.
Go for it. I'll give you the phone number. You can call him yourself.
Okay, we're here investigating a complaint. This woman is in tears, okay? Whatever reason, she's saying, you know, X, Y, Z. Okay, we need to talk to you. Yes, tears, yeah. All right? And we need this to stop because, frankly, this kind of shit, if you'll excuse my language, it, you know, we're here investigating because we have to, but do you know what I mean? There's much more critical things we need to be doing than mediating problems with you adults who can't get along, okay?
The board told us to write a letter.
You have been told it's a civil matter, okay? They don't make the fines. The people who run this complex make the fines, okay? They are responsible for fining and not fining people. If they find that you're in violation, you get fined. If you have a problem with that, you take it up in small claims court with the building, not individual people who live in.
The board told us to write a letter.
He's a board member.
Unfortunately, I can't sue you for slander.
Then
but,
you could have, no,
so you
then
can just
you
go
tell
on.
All of us that.
Everybody knows.
It was in all the newspapers.
Everybody knows what you're about.
It was in all the news. Everybody knows what I'm about.
One lie. That I have been harassing you for years.
Oh.
Tell me, what exactly have I done to harass you for years?
Right, but you're mad at the wrong people.
Board member.
The board member is running.
But you could bring that up to the board. The board has a
right, but you're mad at the wrong people. You have to be mad at the people who run this building.
Board number.
The board number is running.
The board has a right. The board has a right to question that, but we shall hurt. But you could bring that up to the board. The board has a right. The board has a right.
Here investigating a complaint. This woman is in tears, okay? Whatever reason, she's saying, you know, X, Y, Z. Okay, we need to talk to you. Yes, tears, yeah. All right? And we need this to stop because, frankly, this kind of shit, if you'll excuse my language, it, you know, we're here investigating because we have to, but do you know what I mean? There's much more critical things we need to be doing than mediating problems with you adults who can't get along, okay?
That's not real?
That's not real.
Oh, is that what's going on?
So I'll keep praying for you.
Here.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
This
is with
the hint.
This is
with
the
heart.
Gorgeous.
Does anyone believe that he says hello to you and becomes a target?
But I told Pops that. I said, I don't even speak to the troll.
No.
I don't speak to her.
Yeah, nobody does anything.
Punch her on Facebook. She messed around with me. I said, no, but the woman jumped. No, next time she says something, come out here and say something.
Hey, talk to me. I'm listening.
Because it's not worth wasting
my
life.
Talk to me. I'm listening.
Any more than you've already stolen from me.
I have not stolen anything from you.
Whatever's going on, they're the ones calling.
I'm asking a simple question.
No, because you...
Because I'm trying to solve the situation where you acted like you wanted to fix it, and then you just called me a stupid whore.
Because you are.
I am?
You are.
I'm a whore.
All right, no, you're not a whore. You're crazy.
Okay.
You're crazy.
Okay, that's better.
You're
crazy. He's a board member. He's elected by the people who live here.
The board told us to run a red letter. We run a letter.
Well,
get help. There are doctors that will give you medication that will help you.
What will they help me do, Robin? Not get beat up by the prostitute or have a hammer put in my head?
I don't know anything about you getting beat up because I've never seen or heard anything of that.
Oh. Are you doing laundry?
It's too late.
So am I in the way? I guess I know what this conversation is about.
You? If you're they're harassing you all the time, why are you leaving notes outside the door? Why aren't you calling the police the way an adult would?
Is it affecting you? How does it affect you? Are the prostitutes, are they committing crimes against you? Probably not. Okay? All the things that you have problems with, where people park, where the firemen park, all these things, ignore them for 30 days.
Where the firemen park? What are you talking about?
It doesn't matter.
But it does.
But it doesn't matter. No, I just brought that up. But it doesn't matter right now. What you need to do is you need to go on a 30-day sabbatical.
I already did.
No complaining about your neighbors.
I already did. I left home. I drove away.
I don't believe you. I don't believe for 30 days you could go. I don't think you could go for 30 minutes without videotaping them.
Whatever problems that you have with them. This is not the way to solve it. This is the way for you to get locked up for harassment if it continues. Because they keep calling us. They're the ones calling. Whatever's going on, they're the ones calling. You have been told it's a civil matter. Okay? They don't make the fines. The people who run this complex make the fines. Okay? They're responsible for fining and not fining people. If they find that you're in violation, you get fined. If you have a problem with that, you take it up in small claims court with the building, not individual people who live in here. Okay? That's where you're wrong. Now, if you take it and file a claim against the Crest Park management...
He wasn't on the management when it started.
It had nothing to do with management. He's a board member. He's elected by the people who live here.
I filed a form on Friday, which is why they're doing this.
I don't care.
I can tell.
All right? That's not concerned me.
Are you giving that back to me?
I'm only here to deal with the complaint. I really don't care about your lawsuit, their lawsuit, whoever's lawsuit. It's not my concern. I don't deal with civil stuff. I deal with criminal stuff, and you're borderline criminal.
Okay? Borderline,
which is why we're telling you to leave them alone. If they bug you...
I haven't seen them in a week.
If they bug you, pull out your camera on your phone and record stuff. That way you have evidence. I've told them the same thing.
The board has a right. The board has a right.
You... have been told it's a civil matter, okay? They don't make the fines. The people who run this complex make the fines, okay? They're responsible for fining and not fining people. If they find that you're in violation, you get fined. If you have a problem with that, you take it up in small claims court with the building, not individual people who live in here, okay? That's where you're wrong. Now, if you take it... file a claim against the Crest Park management?
He wasn't on the management when it started.
It had nothing to do with management. He's a board member. He's elected by the people who live here.
I filed a form on Friday, which is why they're doing this.
I don't care.
I can tell.
All right? That's not concerned me.
Are you giving that back to me?
I'm only here to deal with the complaint. I really don't care about your lawsuit, their lawsuit, whoever's lawsuit. It's not my concern. I don't deal with civil stuff. I deal with criminal stuff. And you're borderline criminal.
Which is why we're telling you to leave them alone.
If they bug you...
I haven't seen them in a week.
If they bug you, pull out your camera on your phone and record stuff. That way you have evidence. I've told them the same thing. They don't make the fines. The people who run this complex make the fines. Okay? They're responsible for fining and not fining people. If they find that you're in violation, you get fined. If you have a problem with that, you take it up in small claims court with the building, not individual people who live in.
We can go to city court and to the courthouse and find out what it is to the court.
At least we also have to replace those dogs.
Can we go to the only way to do that is to stand out while waiting and have you know when she's going to go out. And if she knows it's happening, she's not going to do it.
We also call the dog and the police on her.
But you could bring that up to the board. The fact that she's got a dog here, the board has a right to question that. The board has a right.
They don't make the fines. The people who run this complex make the fines. Okay? They're responsible for fining and not fining people. If they find that you're in violation, you get fined. If you have a problem with that, you take it up in small claims court with the building, not individual people who live in here.
You might want to bring that up to them. Dan has a dog. Ask Dan about the policy for dogs. Does it have to be wearing a tag or something?
Or do they have to provide the dog out?
Because I looked it up today, I know it's a city law.
Right, you know, why? Because
my life has just gotten worse now. I have to go back to the days of carrying bottles with me all the time,
every day.
It is me.
To anymore, because you know what? I have not done anything to you. In all of these years, I have done nothing. I mind my own business. I come home, I go in my home, I leave, I go to work, I do nothing.
I used to do that.
Shut
too.
Up and let me talk, you
I used
crazy
to do
whore.
That too.
I have done nothing to you. Yet you get away from my car because I don't trust you, you crazy thing.
It took months for my morning glories to grow, and I had to take them off the patio, put them in the kitchen.
What are you talking about?
wall, nigga. They about to start shooting at me. That's what I was doing. Somebody's gonna come out clapping, and I'm gonna get this shit on camera.
Alright, we need another officer
to
front door to help out.
Fuck that, man. Fuck y'all police, nigga. Y'all can suck hard back dick, nigga. Fuck out of here, police ass.
Hard, I'm so rude.
To, oh, you don't put things on some forum or whatever.
Okay.
You go to the management company or the police. That is what you do.
Well, you seem to be pretty convinced that everybody's picking on you.
I'm not talking to you anymore, because you know what? I have not done anything to you. In all of these years, I have done nothing. I mind my own business. I mind my own business.
Yes, I want to make a complaint. I was hard, I was so rude.
There's a reason if you... First of all, let me say, I never had a problem with Jimmy McNair. He seemed like a very nice man. I just never took him seriously because he struck me as just always looking for a way to be famous. And, you know, when I first met him in 2001, which was actually the only time I ever talked to him, he gave me a link to a website, which had a clip on it of himself on Saturday Night Live. And I was like, wow, that's huge. That's impressive. But when I watched it, it was not very good. And he actually didn't do anything except just play the part of a thug sitting at a defendant's table with a really mean face the whole time. And I don't remember a lot much else about the clip, except the feeling that even doing that, he wasn't very good, which is why, I mean, it was years old and, you know, nothing was gonna happen with this guy. And whenever I did see him, he didn't have any talent. I'll just cut to the chase. I hope his kids don't see this, his two kids, well, the daughter especially, she's just a young thing, and I hope she keeps all that money and does amazing things with it. But the rest of the family that I know, and then when I read about the son calling Tracy Morgan out for not mentioning his father on the Emmys or something crazy like that. Like, I mean, $10 million wasn't enough.